Welcome to the NuEyes E2. In this short video, we'll cover the operation of the E2 and its functions. Let's go over what's in the box. First, you'll see the NuEyes E2 VR headset. Now, you'll notice on the side of the glasses are the straps that adjust to fit your head. By simply pulling them away from the Velcro and then reattaching them to fit snug against your head. You'll notice a little bag in the box that holds the wireless remote or wand, a USB cord for charging, and a USB wall charger. First, a little about the device. The E2 has a 4-hour battery life, but can also function by plugging it into a portable USB battery. The battery is not included, but they're relatively inexpensive at any local store that carries electronics. Okay, now for the operation. You will notice there are some buttons on the bottom and side of the glasses. First, the on-off button is located on the bottom right of the glasses. You will feel or see an orange button next to the black on and off button. Now, this is just a tactile button to show where the charger is inserted for recharging. Okay, so hold or press the on button. You'll see a NuEyes logo, and then you'll hear a little jingle. A disclaimer will pop up telling you not to wear the glasses while driving or walking. That's logger speak, but trust me, it's a good idea. Now you'll also see a warning not to let direct sunlight hit the lenses inside of the E2. This could cause permanent damage to the glasses. So when you're outside with the glasses, do not let sunlight hit the inside of your E2. That being said, acknowledge the warning screen in the viewer and proceed with setup. Next, you'll be asked to sync the handheld remote to the glasses by pushing the home button on the remote. If you need to resync the remote to the glasses, simply press that home button on the remote. Now, the glasses are also fully functional if you do not wish to use the remote. Just skip the remote setup and you're on your way. The next thing you'll see is your surroundings through the 8-megapixel autofocus camera. The first button above the home button on the remote controls the zoom. You can zoom out to 18 times and then back by pushing this button or the top right button on the glasses. The first button on the right side of the glasses controls the zoom. Every time you push this button, the optics will appear closer. The bigger button under the zoom in button is the zoom out button. Every time this button is pushed, things will appear to be farther away. On the bottom left of the glasses are two buttons that control the contrast and menu. By pushing this button, the contrast will change from black on white to white on black and then back to color. This button also, if held in, brings you to the adjustment operations menu. Now in this menu, you can adjust the brightness of the glasses, the OCR or optical character reader, go to the internal settings, and lastly, update the glasses when needed. The top right button on the glasses also, when held in, starts the OCR. Which will read text to you from the speakers on the glasses. The home button on the remote and the third button on the right side of the glasses activates the VR mode of the glasses. From here, you'll see the big tile menu, which, once the glasses are connected to Wi-Fi, will let you surf the web, read the Wall Street Journal, and much, much more. Now, when in VR mode, the top round button on the remote or the trigger will act like a mouse to activate or execute the menu item that you've chosen. You can also scroll a menu item up or down by holding down the top button and lifting the wand up or down. Now, if you're not using the remote, you'll see a blue cross that moves with your head movement. Whatever you place the cross on and push the middle button on the right side of the glasses will activate the app or program on the glasses. By holding in the middle button in a program, you can adjust the menu in the program by lifting your head to scroll the menu. To return or go back, look for the round back button on the bottom of the screen and press that to return. To return to reality or camera mode, simply press the NuEyes E2 logo to see your surroundings. As you learn your way around the menu, you'll see different functions to explore, like picture or video mode. This lets you record video and take pictures with your E2 and store them on the glasses. You can also cast your screen to a monitor or computer that's Bluetooth capable, pair to a computer that is capable, change your scene settings, play virtual reality games, and much more. These things are great. From time to time, there will be updates for your device from NuEyes. Not unlike your cell phone, these updates are of no charge. So enjoy your new device. And as always, if you have additional questions or comments, we'd love to hear from you. You can contact us through the NuEyes website or call your representative. Thank you again for your purchase, and we hope this video has been helpful. I'm Robert Blind Dog Cook for Texas iTech and NuEyes. Have a great day, and maybe see the world with NuEyes.